Algerians do not read, a statement that is very common in Algeria. You might hear it on the bus, in the market, or even at university. This grand narrative that is further reinforced by the media is what triggered my interest to investigate reading. So my research aimed at investigating reading practices within a group of graduates in Algeria. It also aimed at investigating the role that reading played in their lives. I spent 3 months in Algeria collecting data, using focus groups, individual interviews, informal conversations, and images. My analysis of the accounts of 9 participants revealed that, like a mosaic that is made up of different pebbles with various colours, my participants' reading identities were coloured by their other identities, such as those related to the languages they speak, their religious practices such as reading the Quran, and their occupations. Now, this is important to capitalise on because it shows how diverse reading identities can be, and therefore how diverse reading interests and the meanings attributed to reading can be. That said, reading should not be limited to one single definition. What was also interesting about my findings was the fact that my participants associated their reading experiences with feelings of guilt and shame. One of my participants, for example, shared her experience of reading on the bus and someone approaching her to say, "Go and read at home, this is no place for reading." And another participant shared her experience of reading in a park and someone approaching her to say, "Go and read something about religion, why would you read a stupid novel?" These impositions led my participants to develop feelings of guilt and shame for not adhering to these imposed rules. This also limited their freedom to read whatever they wanted, whenever and wherever they wanted. From there, my research advocates the need to do a lot more to promote reading, but most importantly, to promote the freedom of choice when it comes to reading. And this starts with you and I. So next time you see someone reading, don't tell them, "Go and read something with more substance," or "Why would you read a trashy novel?" At a national level, educational institutions and ministries of culture should advocate and promote reading of any form. Families should be encouraged to provide a rich, diverse, and reading-friendly environment for their children. Reading is important. It empowers societies, and in order for us to reap its fruits, it's important to promote reading of any kind and reading without any impositions or judgments. And as well argued by one of my participants, reading is a right and people should not judge you for it. Now, the rights that you see on my slide are a few of those advocated by my participants. Thank you very much.